becoming the first risk. How do you protect operational expenses? How do you pay your rent? How do you, I mean, if you're on the golf course and a golf ball flies into the side of your head and you are knocked unconscious for 5 months, what happens? How do you cover your operating expenses in the businesses? So there's certain strategies that one can use in order to protect yourself around these small things that can have a big impact on your business continuity. So again, we look at another small thing called a loan account as a risk to the business. So what is a loan account? Loan accounts are often used by accountants in the industry to reduce taxes in an entity. So you very quickly find that your loan accounts get built up with entries on a set of financial statements. And it's really important that the owner or the owners of a company understand the impact of a loan account. Now, a loan account generally is something owing to you as a business owner. Loan accounts are seen as assets in your estate if you had to die. And it's very interesting to see that accountants use loan accounts to reduce taxes while you're alive. However, it becomes a burden to the group or the company if they are excessive loan accounts that are owing to your estate at death. So if there isn't provision made, the company would have to then say, okay, there was a loan account on these financial statements under the name of the entity we're operating under, which are now owing to the estate. So let's call it 1 million rand. Suddenly the business is going to have to cough up 1 million rand to pay that individual to settle the loan account into the estate. Hence, another potential hang up if something had to happen. So there are mechanisms to protect yourselves around these kind of things. So I've mentioned but three things. There are many more, but there are three things that one can quickly address if one is aware of the potential risk of owning such a thing as a shareholding in a company or a loan account, which is a common thing used by accountants out there. And I'm sure a lot of you might have been exposed to loan accounts. So coming back to the valuation of business, I know under the franchise group within FNB, we do value businesses for the groups out there. And it's a process. But with the right set of information, we do offer valuations for companies. And from that, it's always a good working point to strategize around how you're going to put your company together. If you're planning on expanding and you're turning over 10 or 20 or 30, 40 million rand worth of turnover a year, one really has to consider the structure of your business. Now, business can be structured. First prize would be where a trust owns the shareholding under the legal entity name of your company to try and protect your estate from excessive estate duty costs. Now, remember, SARS is probably the most advanced and well-administered department in South Africa from a government perspective. I take my hat off to SARS. They do their job particularly well. However, if we are aware of the ways to get around not having to pay tax through following certain allowable procedures, then we must follow those procedures. And if we are ensuring that our structures work well and that the company is structured to the effect of considering saving estate duty taxes while in the process of structuring your group and company, well, then you've done the job well. And when I say done the job well, I always challenge a business owner. When I'm face to face with a business owner, the first thing I ask is, if you go home, can you explain to your husband or your wife, if you were to die today, what the impact on your spouse would be today? What debt is there? How are you going to be covering the debt? What happens to your share in the business? What is it worth for income purposes? And how would your spouse be able to respond to your passing if you were the breadwinner? The business will discussion allows a business owner to strategically plan and be put in a position where the owner can go home and explain comfortably to the wife or husband to say, look, here's my plan. If I do die, or if I become disabled, don't worry. Here's the plan. And that to me is so important to the person at home, because it's not only the business owner that's faced with challenges, but the family at home as well. And the reason why I say this is so many South African businesses are family-owned, predominantly family-owned. So the planning and strategic planning around structure, understanding the impact of death and risk to that, understanding the impact of a business partner leaving and the agreements behind that all need to be consolidated and documented in a bulletproof document so that people know how to run the business in future. And it depends on the level of the business that you are in, but it allows the owner comfort and peace of mind knowing that there's a strategy in place and he's ticked the blocks. He can deal with anything if the matters come up. So, I can talk on risk for a lengthy period of time. I know I've been limited to 20 or 25 minutes. I'd quickly like to run through growth and exit strategies. So when we're talking growth strategies, it's so important that when expanding operations, understand the liquidity and liability concerns around borrowing money, understand how a flexible interest rate can really hurt you, and it must be negotiated to the best possible means by proving certain things to a financial institution before they lend you money. Banks these days don't just easily lend money. It's a process. There has to be some kind of a plan. They have to be up-to-date financial statements, and things need to be put in place. If those are in place, the business bankers, whether it be First National or another institution, are equipped to be able to make a decision on lending money much easier. The banks in South Africa are very tight, and we are governed well. And I take my hat off to that because it saved South Africa during the credit crunch a couple of years ago, when the rest of the world was battling the banks throughout, especially America, the Lehman Brothers, for example. They went bang. And it was interesting to see how South Africa responded with our tight banking principles. We don't just lend money easily for a specific reason, that people that have debt owing to the banks can cover the costs, firstly, that don't cause a credit crunch problem. Hence, the challenge to get money through the banks. If there's a plan, a strategy, a document, up-to-date information, it certainly ensures that things are easier when discussing potential growth potential and expanding operation within your franchise. So, on growth, profits can be invested. We offer solutions through our different investment platforms for business owners on how to invest and strategize around growing business assets and considering potential exit strategies. So the growth of a business leads to an exit strategy. And, Daphne mentioned it earlier. She's moving along. In her industry, she owns a funeral parlor. So it's a very challenging industry that Daphne might work in. So how does she exit? And exit strategies are considering a couple of things. Firstly, is there anything else to fall back on for income? If you decide one day you want to go and sit on your stoop at home, drink coffee in the morning and watch the birds, well, then what's paying the rent? And that income stream is often derived from handing over the keys of a business to the next generation. So when it comes to succession planning, how comfortable are you that when you do toss the keys over to your child, are they qualified enough in order to step up to the plate of your old way of working? Do you feel comfortable that your child will be capable of continuing with your negotiated contracts or agreements and have the potential to earn income while you are sitting on your stupid home in retirement.